We will attempt to understand working of DC shunt motor when started using starter. That would be the first point. Second, also find out how armature control is applied to the same motor. And lastly, analyze the response to field control. For such analysis, we will select 2 kilowatt motor with field resistance of 200 ohms and armature resistance of 0.25 ohms. The specified value of voltage supplied to motor is 200 volts and full load speed is 1500 rpm. From this data, we could calculate field current as ratio of supply voltage to field resistance, and the current is 1 ampere. In case of armature circuit, if we estimate 10 amperes of armature current, then armature resistance drop calculates to 2.5 volts. So on deducting this drop from supply voltage, we get full load back EMF as 197.5 volts. All these calculations are shown on the screen for reference. Further, this data tells us that speed of 1500 rpm is, if converted into speed in radians per second, then it calculates to 50 pi. Constant connecting speed and back EMF is 197.5 upon 50 pi, that is 1.2573. We have symbolized this constant as K. Using this constant, we could find out torque as K into IA. So substituting IA equals 10 amperes, we get the torque as 12.573 Newton meters. Now let us consider the circuit diagram of starter shown on screen. We may note that motor needs to be started by inserting 5 resistors in armature circuit that may be removed from armature circuit one by one. For example, if we assume 50 ohms of resistance is included by 5 resistors, armature resistance of 0.25 is negligibly small, so armature circuit will carry approximately 4 amperes of current initially. Torque due to this current is only 40% of full load torque. When each resistance of 10 ohms is removed from armature circuit, torque will rise from 40 to 50 to 66 and then 100% if we ignore back EMF. Back EMF will still reduce the starting current. In this way, depending upon load torque and inertia of rotating parts, transient period shall be decided. After the transient period, motor speed may rise to rated speed and roll of starter completes. And specified full voltage of 200 volts will get applied to armature circuit. Now let us consider armature control of DC shunt motor. As shown on slide, resistance is included in armature circuit of motor. This additional resistance will reduce armature current and available torque. Since field circuit voltage remains constant, magnetic field provided by poles will remain same as before. If we observe the formula for back EMF, then to reduce the value of back EMF, that is reduced due to inclusion of resistance in armature circuit, reduction in speed is only alternative left. This in turn explains that as we keep on including more and more resistance in armature circuit, speed drops from its rated value. Since this control reduces both torque and speed, motor output gets automatically reduced. This way, reduction of speed implies reduction in overall output of motor from 2 kW to some lower value. Finally, if we consider field control of DC shunt motor, then by including resistance in field circuit as shown in circuit diagram, we could reduce magnetic field. This reduction in magnetic field phi m must be counterbalanced by rise in rotor speed n to keep back EMF value eb set by armature circuit. This implies that flux control may be used to rise the speed above the rated speed. Further, if we observe power equation, then that equation suggests that rise in speed may be accompanied by drop in torque or rise in torque if motor output is adjusted by changing armature current. This response of change in output value depends upon load characteristics.